So now in today's experiment, we are going to take the transverse section of another leaf. That one is senna leaf. It is a very small leaf, you can find here. So the procedure what we are following here is again the sandwiching technique. So you have to take a section which consists of both midrib and lamina region. Let's see how to take the section. First you have to cut it into few square section. And you have to take it out. You can find here as it is very small. So it contains, the square section contains both midrib and lamina. Then inside the potato, you make one small division with the help of the blade like this. And the leaf what you have taken, the square section, you put it inside it. So this leaf will be present in the in between the parts of the potato. That's why it is known as the sandwiching technique. Now with the help of the blade, you just take the transverse section in this fashion. Like that, you will find so many sections you take. From that, as I mentioned, lighter the color, thinner the section, darker the color, thicker the section. So you have to find the thickest, thinner section. The thinnest section you have to find. You take it out, put it in safranin solution, let it be there for some time. After that, this section you transfer into distilled water so that the excess of reagent is blown away. After removing the excess of reagent, you place it in cover slide. You place it in the slide. Add some glycerin to it in order to prevent the drying of your slide. After that, you prepare, you place it the cover slip. So be very careful while putting the cover slip. Your slide should not contain any air bubble. The air bubble sometimes cause hindrance to observe the cellular characters. Now your slide is ready. Wipe out excess of reagent. Now your slide is prepared and you place it in the microscope. So let us see what we can find here. Yes. So what we can observe here, you can find both lamina and midrib part. This lamina part mainly consists of mesophyll. Mesophyll consists of both pellicle and spongy parenchyma. Whereas in the upper epidermal part, you will find unicellular covering trichome. Glandular trichome is absent in senna, and you will find needle-shaped calcium oxalate crystals inside the spongy and pellicle parenchyma. In the midrib part, you will find the vascular bundle, which consists of the liquefied xylem and phloem parenchyma. Alternative arrangement of xylem and phloem parenchyma is present. So these are the microscopical characters present in senna leaf. So again I repeat, the epidermal part, which consists of the unicellular covering trichome, followed by you will find the mesophyll, and in the midrib region you will find the alternative arrangement of the xylem and phloem parenchyma, which together is known as the vascular bundle. So these are the various characteristic feature of senna transverse section. Thank you.